The tour's best have conquered the Eastern Front. Fresh off their gold medal at the Goodwill Games in Russia, Carolyn Kirby and Liz Masakayan return to the States to do battle. The question is, are all things quiet on the Western Front?
We don't think so.
Prime Network presents the Coors Light Women's Row Beach Volleyball Tour. This is stop number 12 on the tour. We're at the Promenade in Long Beach for Volleyfest 94. Hi, everybody. I'm Bill McDonald. Guess what? Drew Goodman's not here. You know why? He's honeymooning. Can you believe that, of all things? Man went out and got married. All right, but for continuity, of course, we brought in Maria Barnes, who's here each and every week. This week for Volleyfest 94. A little different, though, Maria, this week, because half as many teams competing.
That's right. We normally have 32 teams, only 16 this weekend. That means no points will be given. However, lots of money still being handed out.
Carolyn Kirby, Liz Masakayan, they proved last week they're the best in the world. They went to the Goodwill Games. They got a gold medal. They're back. That's the big story.
And they were spectacular there. Nobody even gave them a tough game. They played so well, and we're so used to them winning here at home, and we kind of undermine their achievements, but that is amazing. International competition, they are now the best in the world.
Lori Forsythe, Bob Fontana, they were there also. They're pretty darn good. They won a bronze.
That's right. They played well also. Lori Forsythe says it has renewed her enthusiasm about the sport. You can tell she's playing with a little magic.
Interesting situation, though. Because they were gone last week in Russia, both of those two teams, that meant the tournament last week at Pismo Beach wide open, and a team won for the first time.
That's right. Monique Oliver and Gail Stammer won their first tournament. They were spectacular. They beat Catherine Roquet 16-14. Monique Oliver's defense was spectacular.
We've got great volleyball coming up. Why? Well, Oliver and Stammer have made our semifinals. So have the two big guns. It's going to be great here at Long Beach. The Promenade, Volleyfest 94. When we come back after this quick break, we will have semifinal action. So hang with us, please. Prime Network's presentation of the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour is being brought to you by Coors Light. When you want a taste that goes the distance, reach for the silver bullet. Coors Light, keep on moving. By Gatorade, the thirst quencher for that deep down body thirst. And by Reebok.
When we're not looking, governments deny people their basic human rights.
When we're not listening, people are tortured, imprisoned, and killed for their beliefs or simply their identity.
We at Amnesty believe each of us has a moral obligation to see, to hear, and to speak out. Call 1-800-AMNESTY. It's your human right.
Get it moving.
And the silver bullet has the taste to keep it moving. Coors Light. Naturally brewed for a taste that goes down easy. Coors Light. Keep on moving.
Is for all those commercials that show women content with seeing their reflections in dinner plates or coffee tables. Serious performance shoes from Reebok. Available at over 400 Foot Action stores nationwide.
If you're gonna come out to play, you better not fake it.
Kick it! Quench it!
Quench it with Gatorade. Nothing helps you go longer or stronger.
Kick it! Quench it! Kick it!
Word up!
Quench it!
Come on, come on!
Kick it like that!
Gotta get the Gatorade!
Quench it like that!
Give me some!
It's gotta be Gatorade.
Kick it!
To a
7-year-old velocity, mass, and momentum aren't as interesting as the song on the radio. And crash test dummies don't go on family vacations. But the people who buy Volkswagen Jettas do. That's why the new Jetta has dual airbags, front and rear crumple zones, side impact beams, and a rigid passenger safety cage. Velocity, mass, and momentum don't mean much to children, and we plan on keeping it that way.
We're at the Promenade in Long Beach. It's the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour here on Prime. Volleyfest 94. Billy McDonald and Maria Barnes. And here is our road to the semifinals as we get set for our first match. And it's Kirby and Massakainen. And they don't think they've been playing that well, Maria.
Well, these scores don't show that. 15-8 over RC Hera. That's a great team. They beat Oliver Stammer 15-8. But the thing is, they started off up like 10-2 in some of these matches and have allowed these teams to creep back a little bit. So they're not completely on their game. A little fatigue still from traveling home from Russia.
Going up against Deb Richardson and Danny Canoop. And after bageling their first competition, they lost and had to battle through the consolation round.
They're playing great. You see a 15-9 win over Gardner and Schaefer. That's a tough team. And then plowing through Castan Roque, beating them 15-5. You know how good of a team they are. That's a great win for them.
Kirby Massakainen, Richardson, Canoop. Let's pick things up in the middle of a great match. Here we go at 13-10. Denny got to it, but Richardson not able to get. In fact, she just gave it a little wave. No chance that time. Kirby Massakainen, you talked about the pressure on them, but when you're close to beating the champions like Richardson and Canoop, and especially when you've never won a tournament, you're starting to feel a little bit too. And Kirby and Massakainen, they have been in every possible human situation on a volleyball court. So they've been here many
times.
They were
down 13-6 in a final against Castan Roque in Florida this year and came back and won it. So, yeah, you're right. This game's not over. There's a chance.
The one-hand dig. Massakainen! Yes, after the great dig, one-handed. And they're back to within two.
Liz Massakainen, she's so agile. She and Kirby both come up with big plays when they need it, and they kind of take turns with it. If one of them's a little bit off, the other one picks up.
Kirby to serve. You know, Liz is interesting. When you first meet her, she gives the impression that she's taller than she is. She's 5'8". For some reason, when you see her on television, you figure she's a little taller, but she's only 5'8".
She plays big.
Yes, she really does. That's a good pass by Denny after a tough serve, but Massakainen's right there. Chance for the turn. Oh! Couldn't snap that one quite down, and it'll be a side out and a mistake that time by the champs.
Got a bit excited when she saw no block up. Deb didn't bother to go up and block that because the set was so far off the net. He's got a little bit overzealous there.
Yeah, this day and age, any kind of volleyball, you see no block, you start huffing and puffing a little harder.
Great deep serve.
And a chance for Liz again. Boy, the sweet hands of and a sweet set, rather, of Kirby that time. 13-11, Richardson Canoop. Just playing some great defense and being very patient in this match against Kirby and Massakainen. Our first semifinal here at the Volley Fest in Long Beach. Plenty more volleyball to come for you here on Prime. They're trying Canoop. Took a quick and hit it right to Liz. Massakainen with nobody up that time, a bomb. And we take the turn at 12-13.
Kirby Massakainen have steadied out. Playing some great defense. That's a great hit by Liz. That set wasn't even right on the net. She still just unloaded on that ball.
And after going down 13-10, two in a row for Massakainen and Kirby to draw to within one. Liz and Carolyn taking a break, and you know it's been a hectic week for them. A little earlier in the weekend, Maria had a chance to catch up with the dynamic duo and talk about their experience at the Goodwill Games.
The gold medal at the Goodwill Games, would you say that was the highlight of your career so far?
So far, I think for Carolyn and I, it was our number one goal this year and a really good stepping stone for the future in the Olympics. It was a great experience.
What's the difference between that and the Olympics to you as a player, having been there?
For us, it's a, like Liz said, a stepping stone for the next opportunity to play for a medal and to represent the United States. So it's a very patriotic experience to be over there and to know that you have a chance for a medal and that you're representing the U.S. So it was really, really an awesome experience for us.
You know, that's such an impressive achievement for them, because the field that is now in this international competition is not a whole lot different from what they're going to see at the Olympics.
Gold to Kirby and Masakaya. Let's get back to the action. Got a great match going here in our semifinal. Hope you're enjoying it. Now Liz Masakayan, as they change sides, and if there is a good side, as we mentioned, it's the side that Kirby and Masakayan are on right now. But the breeze is slight. In fact, the flags, as Maria points to me right now, hanging straight down. We feel a little bit here, though. They got to feel just a bit there. Tie, 13 all.
We got a tie ball game, 13 all.
You can feel it now, can't you? And a quick timeout. Boy, right after a side change, too, you make a mistake like that. Good serve, but it should have been handled by Canute.
Yeah, I don't know if you can call it a mistake, but there's a lot of velocity on the serve. Yeah, you're right. That was bad ball control. It was a tough serve, but she could have handled it better.
Didn't really have to move too much for it.
No, but that doesn't mean that the ball's not moving.
Right, it was dipping. Dipping down and away to her left that time. It was a great serve by Liz.
Kind of tough to see from where we are, but...
It was actually on that angle. You could see she put a little, screwball action on it.
Yeah.
And now we're 13 all.
I wouldn't have wanted to be passing that ball, that's for sure.
You're still playing ball, though, aren't you?
Oh, here and there. Nothing worth talking about, though.
Then we won't. I was thinking about striking up a conversation, but that went dead in the water right there. What a big win this would be for Richardson and Canute. We cannot say it enough, because they have never won a tournament, and what a great opportunity to do it right here.
Certainly no strategizing going on under their umbrella. They're very intense right now.
But on the other side, and you talk about it a lot, that if there's one of many great things about Kirby and Masakayan, it's their ability to change and go with the flow during any kind of match. They can just, boom, like a faucet, turn it on and off in a different mode.
They're problem solvers.
Yes.
And the key is that they don't wait until the match is over to solve their problems. They make adjustments throughout the entire match, and that is what separates them from any other team out here. Most teams have to lose and then look back at what went wrong.
At 13 all, Masakayan serves, and that's just out. Ooh, tough to.
Gotta make that serve after a timeout.
Yeah, and actually, you're not going to go for Richardson that time. Was just hoping that was going to sail wide, because no way she was going to pass that ball. 13 all, big serve to try to get to game point. Canute. Once again, Masakayan, who sees the majority of the serves. She goes angle. A touch that time by Richardson. He said, I should have had that one. But it's a side out, and Kirby will serve.
Richardson's so feisty, has very high expectations for herself.
When they lost to this team at Myrtle Beach, it was 15-13. Two more points in a row by Canute and Richardson. It would be deja vu all over again, but that one goes long, and it brings Kirby and Masakayan out of game point.
That was a high set, tough to hit, coming up over your head like that. You've got to keep the ball in, though.
Looking for five in a row and to move into the finals again. Kirby to serve. Canute, and that set is off, two, and it goes long, and the game's over.
What a comeback. Kirby and Masakayan do it as well as anyone. They are so composed and confident.
And it was the mistakes by the other team, not just great plays by Kirby and Masakayan, that really did in Richardson and Canute.
Well, you know, on those two sets off the net there at the end of the game, you've just got to keep those balls in. You don't go for the great play. You've got to be confident in your ability to continue to side out and just keep the ball in. And you saw Denny there hit the ball long. It's a tough set, but still, you've got to keep the ball in.
Well, the champions have a chance for another title. We'll see them again in the finals
here at the Volley Fest in Long Beach.
Well, you bargain hunters have waited for it. It's here now at Hammond Ford Chrysler Plymouth Dodge, our 94 model sellout. The best time of year to buy that new car truck you've been wanting. Not only our continued goal of prices, at least $300 less than the competition for the same exact model, but during this sellout, every factory incentive, every rebate, every special package, every discount available is applied to your purchase of all remaining 94 Hammond cars and trucks. But only while they last. Don't wait. Hurry to Hammond Ford Chrysler. A few money-saving minutes from anywhere.
TCI Cablevision is proud to support the efforts of citizens and organizations in the greater Houston area. 24 Houston police officers are biking 3,800 miles to raise money for the Leukemia Society, and TCI is sponsoring a member of their relay team. TCI sponsors the Terminators softball team in Dickinson, coached by Janice Sawyer, an employee from our Bay Area office. During Child Abuse Prevention Month, TCI donated $16,000 to child advocates to protect abused and neglected children. TCI Cablevision, supporting your community efforts.
In a 93 nail biter, Martina took her 8th LA title. Can she claim number 9? A high-ranked court will decide at the Virginia Slims of Los Angeles. Semifinal coverage begins Saturday at 9 Central, live on HSE.
That is Long Beach, California. We are here, the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour. We're getting into it now. Semifinal number 2. Time to look at how these two teams got here. Maria, Fontana, and Forsythe back from the Goodwill Games, and they're rolling.
Yeah, they're playing really well. A 15-9 win over Castron Roque. That's a good finish. They were in control that entire match.
They're going up against Monique Oliver and Gail Stammer, straight off of their first ever win at Pismo Beach. And that Anderson-O'Hara match was something to behold.
Yeah, they had to have been fatigued going into the semifinal because they played a long, grueling match against Anderson and O'Hara and made a tremendous comeback.
They're going to try to win and go up against Kirby and Matsakayan again, who are waiting for the winner of this semi. Well, we had a great first semi. It was close. Semi two, a different story. Let's get to it. And a mistake there by Lori.
Notice how tall Gail Stammer is at 6'2". She's one of 5 girls in her family. The whole entire family is over 6 feet tall.
Play some hoop with that bunch.
Including mom and dad.
Oh, man.
Can you imagine the attention they must get when they go places?
Can you imagine what the house looks like? They've redone the doors and everything else over there. The set by Fontana, a little tight that time, but Lori Forsythe puts it right down, and it's a side out at 12-1. This has been a blowout, really, from the beginning. Stammer and Oliver not really getting any kind of rhythm going. And it's really going to bode well for Forsythe and Fontana because they're going to go up against their nemesis, of course, in Kirby and Matsakayan in the final if they hold on. And they're conserving some energy here with a quick win.
That's true, especially when you consider Kirby and Matsakayan played an hour and 13-minute semifinal match against Richardson and Canoop. They're tired. They were tired coming into this match. But Barb and Lori will have a lot more energy. You notice Barb's shoulder taped there. She tore her rotator cuff at a tournament in Rhode Island earlier this year. And she says that it's totally back to normal, that the tape is now just a little safety measure for her.
Do you believe her?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
She said it was really nice at the Goodwill Games to play and not be in pain for the first time.
13-1. Actually, 14-1 as they've reached game point here in semifinal number 2.
The way they're playing right now, it does not seem she is in any pain at all.
With a timeout, time now to tune into our WPVA Beach Network. Our correspondent, she travels worldwide. Her name is Maria Barnes. Maria.
Michelle Gazza from Sugarland, Texas, asks the Beach Network, I was wondering about the off-season, if there is one, in Pro Beach Volleyball. Are there other tournaments? Do you do appearances? Do you take time off? Do you train with your partners? What's the deal? So we thought we would ask some of the players, what is the deal, Barbara?
Well, there is definitely an off-season for the national tour, but if you're in the top 2, you also play the international circuit, which Lori and I and Liz and Carolyn will be doing this year. My biggest match, honestly, is going to be in October when I get married to my fiancé, Charlie.
So, Krista, what's the deal?
Well, in the off-season, I try to recuperate from the season, but I plan to play a little bit in Australia.
Yoga.
Little rest?
A lot of workout, a lot of yoga, a lot of massage.
I do some coaching.
Being a mommy.
Substitute teacher.
Work on my serve.
So what am I doing in the off season? I don't know, maybe I'll have another bambino. Going to some valley, do a little fly fishing. Maybe run a marathon or two. But Phil, the question for you is, what's the deal?
Well, the deal is, Maria, it's the WPVA Beach Network. Please send questions, faxes, or tapes to Prime Network care of WPVA Beach Network, 5251 Gulfton Street, Houston, Texas, 77081. Or please fax us. There's the number. We love faxes. 713-661-8378. That is the deal. Let's get back down to the court.
Ladies, return to the court after
it's about
the
to be lights
game.
Out here in semifinal number two. Forsythe Fontana all over Stammer and Oliver, 14-1. So Barb Fontana serving for the game and to move into the finals against Kirby and Massachusetts. They're working Stammer right here.
Stammer getting
the set by Monique Oliver. Gail Stammer.
Oliver back.
The most improved player on tour back in 1990. She won that award.
You know, most teams go after Monique, and they have throughout most of this match, given that, you know, Gail's obviously stronger and is able to put the ball down much more easily than is Oliver.
And a good play by Oliver and Stammer as they net their second point and 2-14 as we extend this semi just a bit on a warm day here in Long Beach.
I would imagine it's tough to come back and play really well after the high of winning your first tournament, as Oliver and Stammer did last weekend.
That one falls in.
Forsythe and Fontana have just played really steady this match. They've made very few mistakes. They've kept the pressure on with tough serving. And every chance they've had for a point, they have converted on.
Fourth time these two teams have met this year. Fontana, Forsythe have won two out of the three. Myrtle Beach was when Oliver and Stammer won. So Myrtle Beach seemed to be an upset venue.
Oh, it really was. It was very windy the first 2 days of the tournament, and that's why you saw so many upsets. The wind's kind of an equalizer and wreaks some havoc for some of the teams there.
Tight set, but Oliver finds it with the pound, cross court, right hand, and it's a serve now at 14-2.
Talked about Monique's strength. She's also a really quick player. That's a nice, sharp turn cross court for her. She and Gail have had a great season for them. A lot of fourth place finishes.
This will be Fontana. Nice little cut there and turned it perfectly.
Barbara's favorite shot. She can hit that probably 99 out of 100 times. Cut shot from the left side of the court.
And they know it's coming, too, and they still can't get it.
I know.
Isn't that great? You freeze in the sand a bit. You just don't want to go get it because she'll just pop it long on you next time. Oliver, there. This could be the game right here at 14-12. Fontana, it's over.
Wasting no time and no energy. It is hot here. They closed it out quickly, conserving all of their energy for the final against Kirby and Massachusetts.
Barb Fontana, the shorter of the two, so she's going to see a lot of the serves, and she puts it away for the game winner.
Nice, tough serve, nice and deep. Monique handles the ball really well, but just is not able to put the ball away. And Barbara moving so well in the sand. She's such a great defensive player. Comes up with a big play for her team. It's got to feel good for her to be able to swing away at a ball after having a really sore shoulder for several weeks now. And she's just right back on her game, moving as well and hitting as well as I've ever seen her.
This is our Gatorade play of the semi. Semi number one tied at 10-10. Key sequence right here. Massachusetts serving. Richardson has a chance now for the side out, but look at Carolyn Kirby. The defense getting wet right there. Massachusetts on the set. Kirby can put it away, but no. Richardson right there. She'll get the set now from her partner, Canoop. She cannot poke it home as Kirby plays some great defense again, but then Richardson moves over and slaps it down with the left hand to make it
our Gatorade play of the semis. Once again, our final score here in semi number two, it was a blowout. Forsyth and Fontana moving on to the finals, winning 15-2. When we come back, our championship match, it's going to be a great one. The two best on the beach going at it again. Do not go away.
Coors Light. Keep on moving.
I built the entire city of Seattle on the roof of my car.
Now my car has wings, feathers, and a beak.
A little glue, a few seeds, just add water, and voila!
It's not what you add on to our car that makes it more fun. It's what you take off. The Del Sol from Honda.
Right now, your Honda dealer is offering attractive lease rates on the Del Sol S.
We are back, Long Beach, California. We have reached that time. It's the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour. Volley Fest 94, get ready to party because we are about set to go with our final. Kirby Massacion against Forsyth and Fontana. This should be a classic. And right now, courtside with Lori Forsyth is our Maria Barnes.
Thanks, Bill. All right, Lori, first of all, congratulations on the bronze medal at the Goodwill Games. Second of all, you won your semifinal match 15-2. Kirby and Massacion had a 76-minute grueler. Do you have the advantage at this point?
I think that we're going in a little more rested, but that's not to say that we have an advantage or anything like that. They're a tough team, and so Barbara and I are playing really steady this weekend, and that's what we plan on doing this game, is playing steady and passing the ball.
Phil, you have the advantage in that you played so many matches in Russia this last week.
Yeah, we play a lot of variety there because of all the international players. You see a lot of different stuff that you normally don't see out here, and I think it does give us a little advantage.
All right, Lori, good luck. All right, Forsyth is ready to go. Bill?
Thank you, Maria. I guess if there's a silver lining in all this, the gold and bronze medalists are going at it for the championship here in Long Beach. Now, we are set to go for the introductions of our players, the voice of the tour, Denny Lennon.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to downtown Long Beach, California, for the final of the Long Beach Volley Fest. All right, volleyball fans, it's time to meet the players. First, standing 5'6" out of Manhattan Beach, California, 1994 Goodwill Games bronze medalist, Barbara Fontana. Checking in at 6'1" out of Encinitas, California, the other half of that bronze medal team, Lori Forsyth. Standing 5'11" out of San Diego, California, Goodwill Games gold medalist, Carolyn Kirby. And finally, standing 5'8" out of San Diego, California, Goodwill Games gold medalist, Liz Mazikian.
And those are introductions, and done in great style, of course, once again by Denny.
All right, Long Beach, one more time.
The conditions here, it's hot, to tell you the truth. It's a sandbox. We'll tell you about that in a little bit. Man-made, of course, court here at the promenade in Long Beach. They carted in a whole bunch of hard-packed sand. Our temperature, 82, but it certainly feels a lot hotter down on the court. The win, negligible. We are underway. This is our final, and serving, of course, Fontana and Forsyth, but right away, the big pound of Liz Mazikion, and we are set and underway. Keys right here, Liz, as you get up. Once again, thank you for joining us.
The key to this match.
The key is the fatigue factor is definitely on the side of Kirby and Massakai. However, they do have something to prove. They haven't played that great this weekend. You need to look for some crafty play from Fontana and Forsyth. Lots of shots, not a lot of balls being put down hard. And Kirby and Massakai, we'll see some aces and some tough serving from them.
That one hit out, so it's 1-0 Kirby and Massakai. And as far as the fatigue factor with the jet lag and being in Russia, once again, both of these teams were there, so that's equal in that factor, winning the gold and the bronze. And the big hit there with nobody up by Forsyth. Massakai cannot negotiate the dig, and it is side out to Forsyth and Fontana.
The difference, though, is that 76-minute semifinal match Kirby and Massakai played, they said they're just mentally exhausted.
95 side outs in that one. That one drifted a little close, but Massakai able to use the block that time for the side out. So the wind maybe picking up just a bit. It was blowing into the faces of Kirby and Massakai earlier. We'll see if it has shifted here at the Promenade in Long Beach. Kirby and Massakai have won 9 events this year. This is Carolyn Kirby, the best on the beach. Good up that time. And beautiful placement by Carolyn Kirby. Now complimenting her very well is Liz Massakai, and I want to get into Liz right after this replay.
Well, you know, this just shows you why Carolyn Kirby is the best player on the beach. That sets 10 feet off the net. She still takes the time to look at the other side of the court, see the open hole, and then she hits it.
We'll save that thought on Liz Massakai when we come back after this. We take our first break with a score 2-0. Kirby and Massakai. No flipping around. We'll see you in a minute.
Houston fans, you asked for it. Now you've got it. Sports Illustrated commemorates your 1994 NBA championship with this special Houston Rockets souvenir issue. Call now, and you'll also get the official 1994 NBA Finals video. And best of all, go for free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. With your free Rockets championship video, you'll capture the unforgettable moments of the 94 playoffs. From an incredible triumph over the Suns, to victory over the Jazz, and on to the championship over the Knicks. And with your free Rocket souvenir issue, you'll get a collector special to savor forever. Call now, use your credit card, and get your Rockets championship video and souvenir issue along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. Nobody plays basketball like the world champion Houston Rockets. Nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
I see for the future of golf is the technology in golf clubs, shafts, bowls, ball covers, game improvement equipment.
Here's our story early on in our final on Prime. Kirby Massakai and 2 quick ones over Fontana and Forsyth in our championship match. And Kirby and Massakai right now, easily, comfortably in the league for our Chevy Pro Challenge. They accumulate points throughout the year, and our winners or winner at the end will get their choice of a new Chevy. I think I'm picking up a new Chevy truck towards the end of the year, and Kirby Massakai will probably look good behind the wheel. There's Liz Massakai. We were talking about this partnership between these two, Carolyn Kirby and Liz Massakai, for the last couple of years. Liz's game so much better than it used to be. She does a dozen pounds. She really has a new repertoire of shots this year.
That's true. For so long, Massakai would go up and hit every ball. She loves to hit, and she's got the best setter on the beach setting her. Who wouldn't? But she's really mixed things up. She's got a lot of shots now. She's learned that you can't be successful just banging away at every ball.
That time, the block right back down, but a good effort, however, in a side out.
Great play by Forsyth. But to finish my thought, it's like a fastball pitcher in baseball. You can't throw a fastball every single pitch. You've got to mix it up with the changeup. Volleyball is no different. You've got to have shots, or you're going to get dug.
And there's a great shot right there.
That's a great shot by Forsyth. She's the shot queen.
Barb Fontana, the smallest out there on the court. Boy, does she play big. And she has a chance here to get the first point of the match, and she does with a big pound to the open court.
Their Barb first Fontana. Point of the match.
That's right. 2-1.
Barbara putting that ball away.
Barbara's excited that she's playing healthy. You can see that she has her shoulder taped. She tore her rotator cuff just slightly and has been injured for the past few tournaments, but she says it is now healthy. It doesn't bother her at all. She says it feels great to be playing without pain for the first time in quite a while.
And she always plays with a lot of confidence. That's a tough serve that time. Mazakaya trying to make something out of nothing. That's going to sail long and quickly. 2 points after the timeout. Villar to Fontana and Forsyth. And Barb will go back and serve again.
Given that both teams are fatigued, and especially mentally fatigued with all of their travel, it's just very important for them to play steady and minimize their errors.
Out of UCLA, Masakayan off the block again. It'll be side out to Kirby and Masakayan. 2-2 here. This is to 15. Got to win by two. We'll go to sundown if we have to here in our final at Long Beach. These two teams going at it again. Fontana and Forsyth have come in second to Kirby Masakayan four times already this year, but they beat him at Myrtle Beach 15-12. The stretch by Liz, but a good little cut shot that time by Lori. A little cut dink, and it's side out at 2-2.
There's Mary Jo Pepler, the coach of Kirby and Masakayan, an ex-Olympian herself. You know, I was talking with her before this match. She was telling me that because Kirby and Masakayan are so fatigued, it's hard for them to think clearly, and that's the reason that we have seen them play so up and down and make so many mistakes, but no mistake made there by Masakayan.
Easily one of their strong suits, because we mentioned in the semi that they can adjust throughout the match at any point. They're maybe the smartest team out there.
They're the best problem solvers of any team on the beach, and they don't wait to lose to do it. They adjust constantly throughout their play, and that's what separates them.
The high toss caught by Kirby. She'll try it again. Okay. She's got to do it this time. You only get one restart, if you will. And a service error. So side out going out of Forsyth and Fontana.
You know, you see Kirby and Masakayan both make a lot of hitting serving errors, and it's because they swing hard at every ball. It's rare that you see them not use a jump serve, and they both have such powerful serves.
That's a good serve also, short. Getting a little wet that time, Masakayan. After another sensational one, a big hit by Liz to put it away. That's some good stuff, good rally. Best one of the match so far.
Barbara Fontana is so quick, always coming up with a big defensive plays, and that was smart of Masakayan to terminate the point on two. Here you see the scramble play by Forsyth. That's a great up by Forsyth, but then Barb just dives in there, keeps the ball in play. It's a great play by Liz. Whenever you can catch the defense off guard and go over on two and hit like that, it's always a smart thing to do.
Good. Pass. Set, hit, but dug that time by Masakayan. They're the best hands on the beach, setting Liz Masakayan for the pound.
The amazing thing about Kirby is it doesn't matter where the pass is. She will pull those hands out and use them. And Masakayan's so lucky to have her as her setter.
I'll take her anytime. Watch this. Rocket ship into the sand. We're going to take the turn. 3-2. When we come back, more great action in our final here from the Promenade in Long Beach. Do not go away.
The new Volkswagen Jetta GLX was built for the Autobahn, where people go 130 miles an hour. You, however, cannot. If you could, it would look a lot like this. And a little like this.
This is for all those commercials that show women content with seeing their reflections in dinner plates or coffee tables. Serious performance shoes from Reebok. Available at over 400 Foot Action stores nationwide.
Because many places in the world come with crowbars as standard equipment, the new Volkswagen Jetta comes with an anti-theft alarm system as standard equipment, too.
To play professional soccer inside the Summit, we had to cut the field in half. Of course, that just made the action twice as fast. Touchdown!
We didn't think you'd mind.
Catch all the action when the Hotshots take on the Washington Warthogs August 17th. Sponsored by Powerade Randalls and Estereo Latino 93.3 FM.
Western Auto has over 100,000 parts available when you need them 7 days a week. Serious parts at serious savings. Hey, we know what you want.
Save on Castrol Motor Oil now at Western Auto. Castrol, maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown.
Western Auto, no stranger to these parts.
Welcome back to Long Beach Volleyfest 94 on Prime Network. I'm Bill McDonald along with Maria Barnes. Dev Richardson is having a great year, currently ranked 7th on tour. And on Inside Dig, she talks about what it is that keeps her focused.
We all know what Deb is like on the court. What's Deb like off the court?
Off the court, I think I live a pretty simple life. I like to stay home a lot, do a little working out, do pottery, and I take kung fu classes in the off season. And I like to eat.
What do you eat?
Anything. I'm real careful about what I eat. I don't eat any processed foods, no sugar, no dairy, things like that. So I'm real careful.
Someone walks up to me and says, so what's Deb like? How would you answer that question for me?
As a volleyball player?
No, as a person.
Just as a person, I would hope people would say that I'm pretty honest and open and just down to earth. You know, I think I'm a little intimidating, once because of my size, and I'm kind of quiet. But I think when people get to know me, I'm pretty laid back and mellow.
What makes you successful?
Successful in volleyball?
Mm-hmm.
Just my drive to keep going and going and going. I love the game, and there's always something you can get better. You can always get stronger, you can always get faster, you can always... There's endless things to do.
Have you peaked?
No. I have... I could probably play for 10 more years if I felt like it.
You're healthy?
Very healthy.
Really? Wow. 10 more years, that would make you...
I don't think I'm going to play 10 years. I could see playing a couple, three more years.
She should be healthy. No dairy and no sugar sounds like no fun to me.
I'm not on that diet. Here's our championship match. And by the way... We had a great tournament, did Deb. Kirby Masakaya now over Fontana in fours. I bet it's early, 3-2, as Liz will take it. These two teams have played many times throughout their career. And it's the 28th meeting between the two. Kirby Masakaya winning 23 of the matches.
Good.
They've won 7 out of 8 this year, including the last 5. Those are the numbers. This is the action. Easy dig that time. The block, not effective. 4-2.
It's another way Masakine's really matured as a beach player. She used to get blocked a lot more by Forsythe, and now she is doing a better job of tooling Rory and seeing her and hitting off of her block. I just saw her do there.
Masakayan, born in the Philippines, attended UCLA, 7th year out here on tour. Former national team member. Over on to smart play by Barb Fontana. Let's talk about Barb Fontana a little bit, her strengths out here on the beach.
She has got enough confidence for about 10 people, basically. I mean, she is so confident, so intelligent, a very crafty player, very quick player, and she just believes that she can win, and that's why they do.
Hey, you know, she's smart. She went to Stanford. Got to have some grades to get in there. Big hit, and finally down. Good power that time by Kirby. But showing some presence there with the block, of course, is Forsythe.
You know, another thing about Barbara is that she is so intense. I mean, in talking with she and Lori, Lori kind of mellows her out a little bit. But Lori says she's so stingy with the number of points she'll let us give away to anyone. She says, I don't care if we're talking, practicing, eating. She is intense. I mean, everything she does. You know, she does with such conviction, and that's what makes her such a great player.
That's a great bump set right there by Forsythe. Digging a little bit in the sand right there to get that pass, but watch this. It's right on top, and a nice put away by Fontana.
Lori's always been a great bump setter. She has such ball control. She's so consistent.
And straight down the middle that time, splitting the defense.
There is Lori Cotis Forsythe, and the serve by her partner. That's going to be tight. Joust at the net. Won that time by Forsythe. And that's a point, and it's three serving four.
Massakine's been working on her hand setting. You saw her pull her hands out there and set Caroline, and it was a nice set, not an ounce of spin. Just a little bit too tight to the net. Didn't leave Caroline much room to do anything with that.
Groveling that time was Liz Massakine. They get set now for the serve of Fontana. That one hits the net. And we will side out now to Liz Mazikion and her partner Carolyn Kirby.
Both of these teams have talked about how much they learn by playing internationally. They pick up so many things from the other teams. You know, the Brazilians have such a quick game, such a finesse game. One of the Brazilian players went up to Lori and said, how do you play when you're so tall?
I guess I have to.
I mean, it's the opposite of the thinking here in the United States, but most of the Brazilian players are only like 5'6", and they have a totally different style of play than we do here.
Carolyn Kirby a little upset that time, maybe about the pass. Kirby takes charge, doesn't she, out there?
Yeah, she really does.
She's the boss in that relationship.
Actually, they claim that it's pretty even. In fact, Massakian is the more outspoken one of the two normally as far as personalities go. Massakian's the type A. Kirby's the more laid-back one of the two.
Kirby leading 4-3. Serving. This will be Forsythe. Pushed out by Fontana, the line. Could get that time by Kirby. Chance for a point. She moves in. And Fontana's all over it. Great up. Overset Mazikaya. Yes. Good stuff, both teams, but really. Kirby and Mazikion, they were dead and buried on that rally, but they get a point, and it's 5-3.
Carolyn Kirby surprised herself here. She was moving in one direction and dug the ball their opposite hand. She had already committed, and then Mazikion just terminating there. What a play by Kirby and Mazikion.
Just reaction by Liz Mazikion to get it up and over. That's a big serve, and that was going to find the court. Would have probably kissed the tape. Tough that time for Lori.
That's the difference between Kirby and Mazikion is they both have good, strong jump serves. Here you see, Carolyn, this is a great serve because it's a good, deep serve. It's always tough to pass a serve that's coming right at chest level.
At 6-3, Carolyn Kirby to serve. Good pass. Blocked by Mazikion. Fontana's going to have to go retreat. And pop it over. Way to stay with that. You've always got to be ready after you hit one because it could be coming right back in your face.
Yep, you never know when it is.
Saving a point on the play.
Especially because all of these players get out of the sand. Get up and over and block the net. Notice the tape job on Barbara Fontana's shoulder. At this point, it is just precautionary. She says the pain's gone, but it makes her feel more secure to have that there. Kind of a newfangled way of taping by Dr. Tim Brown, who taped her back for her. She leaves it on for like 4 and 5 days at a time. Pretty nasty, huh?
Exactly right, but she wins doing it. I'm not going to argue with it. Back with more in a minute. We take the turn at 6-4. Kirby and Mazikion. See ya when we come back.
When we're out riding herd on the old Texas range where the deer and the antelope roam, we're mighty dang grateful there ain't nothing strange messing up our beautiful home. No garbage, no litter, no trash anywhere. It's a beautiful sight to behold. If I could only remember what my old pappy said.
Oh, yeah! Don't camp in the road!
Hi, my name is Jeff Horney, and this is my service dog, Tyler. Tyler is one of the many service dogs trained free of charge by Texas Hearing and Service Dogs, a nonprofit organization. Tyler helps me every day by picking up things I drop, fetching my wheelchair, and 100 other things. He's a real icebreaker, too. They adopt their dogs from animal shelters, so they're helping dogs as well as people. Tyler goes everywhere with me, even to restaurants. To learn more about service dogs, call these numbers.
Bicycle safety? Not by a long shot. One of the only bike racing tours that's won in the air. APA World Cup from Toledo, Saturday night at 6 on HSE.
We are back at 6-4 in our contest here in the championship, but we have more volleyball coming your way on Prime. It's the best of the beach. We go at it to see who the best individual is. It'll be in Las Vegas, Nevada, October 11th. Please check your local listings for the time of the best of the beach, October 11th in Vegas. And this is what they made here.
It's like a huge sandbox.
Let's go play
it. Like a foot and a half of sand that they've brought in. And it's a pretty good surface, kind of hard packed, however.
Always is when you man make it, yeah.
That's true. It's our fake beach.
Good stuff. That time by Forsyth and Fontana, keeping it alive off the net. Big shots, but no serve. Speaking of beaches and sand, because it's interesting here because it is hard packed, the deepest sand you've ever played and deepest beaches around.
Manhattan.
Easily.
Yeah, Manhattan and Hermosa, by far.
The South Bay, a little tough to jump there. And any time a volleyball tour of any kind finds its way downtown someplace, you know it's going to be a jumper's paradise.
This is a really, this facility was put together pretty well, though. This is a good, that's a lot of sand to have a foot and a half on a man-made surface.
Last
put together by, I think, Marty Carrillo did this surface for us.
Big bad Marty. That last serve hit the net, so it was a side out at 6-4 for that one, the battle at the net. And the joust, it will belong now, side out to Kirby and Masakayan.
Normally when Kirby and Masakayan are playing Fontana and Forsyth, they try to keep their sets a little bit off the net, because Lori is such a strong force at the net.
Any bad blood between these two teams?
You know, there used to be, but when before this match started, I walked back in the players' tent, and all four of them were sitting around rapping. Said that playing at the Goodwill Games kind of built some camaraderie between them. They had a chance finally where they weren't playing against each other. They could cheer each other on. They said it was really fun.
Good stuff. And now they're back playing against each other again. Renewing the rivalry at 4-6, Barbara Fontana. Quick bump. Oh, Liz really put some power into that one, didn't she? And turned it well.
She just was springing out of the sand. That was a pretty impressive vertical jump on that hit. Take a look at this. Kaboosh. Barbara Fontana was in pretty good position to dig that ball, but she just unloaded on it.
Another thing I mentioned earlier is that Liz Mazakayan, when you first see her either on television or in person, she seems to be a lot taller than she really is, but you mentioned that statement that she plays big, and she really does. She makes the great defensive play. We're talking about her, and she does it right there.
That's what I'm talking about. I mean, she has gotten so much craftier. The fact that she dives and digs this ball, she had every intention of hitting that back over. I mean, that was no coincidence there, and that comes from playing against those Brazilian teams. They're so crafty, and you can learn a lot from them.
7-4 now. Montana, perfect pass. Sets a little tight, nobody up. Pretty good velocity on that, but a chance for the point. 8-4. Oh, nobody around for that one. Nowhere to move it. Forsyth, right back at ya.
Forsyth putting Kirby in the phone booth. Just stuffing her. Let's take another look at that. Up and over quickly. It's a great block.
Great job by Fontana, too, not to net on her big swing before. She was very close. Had to do the limbo, not to net. Get caught up at 4-7. After that, great block, and they turn it into a point. Not this time, side out.
It's really tough for both Kirby and Masakayan because they both love to swing at the ball. And you will see them get dug a little bit more, and you will see them get blocked a little bit more because they do just swing away, but they are so fun to watch.
And it is 7-4 here at Long Beach. Our story, Kirby and Masakayan trying to win again. after winning the gold over on two and out. Well, a little bit of I got it, you take it that time by Fontana, but she hit it out, and it cost her team a point, 8-4.
There's a little unspoken rule, at least back when I used to play volleyball, that if you were going to go over on two like that, it better go in because you're not giving your partner a chance to hit the ball.
I don't know if that has to be unspoken. You might as well go ahead and tell him. Hit it in if you're going to do that. Barb's steaming a little bit. You can see it.
Yeah, but you know what? On the other hand, the only way to beat Kirby and Masakayan is to play crafty.
Sure.
You've got to take risks against them.
Low set again. Good dig. Masakayan trying to go 9-4. And it's a little bit of a mini run. They need a timeout right now, and we're going to get one. Smart timeout by Fontana and Forsyth. We'll take a break right here. Right now, the champs in charge by 5. But more volleyball to come when we return to Long Beach. Stay with us on Prime.
Southwest Airlines Home Run Derby Sweepstakes. From June 19th through August 31st, if an Astro or Ranger hits a home run in the designated inning, you can win 2 round-trip tickets on Southwest Airlines. In addition, 4 grand prize trips for 2 will be awarded to join the Astros or Rangers on the road in September. Send a postcard with your name, address, age, and phone number to this address. Watch and win with HSE and Southwest Airlines. Providing low fares, frequent flights, and legendary customer service. Fly Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart.
We are back, Long Beach, California. Billy McDonald along with Maria Barnes. You know, Liz Masakayan took time off from her busy schedule to give us her opinion on who's the best on the beach in a wide variety of skills and other activities. It's How We Play the Game, brought to you by Reebok.
Hi, it's Liz again. And all year long, we've been watching on How We Play the Game, all the pros, trying to tell you what's right, what's wrong, and all the basic skills, but... You know, I watched a few of those, and I think it's my turn to tell you my opinion on, you know, who I think's best at each skill. So, I don't know, where should we start? Setting. Hitting, blocking, defense, and serving. We can start right now, because my partner's the best at all of them. Okay, goodbye. Okay, let's see. My vote on the best blocker is Elaine Roque, because she's of the same blood as me. let's see. Best setter... Of course, my partner. Everyone knows that. Carolyn Kirby. Best defense. Well, I like Barbara because she's small like me. You know, us small players, 5'8 and below, don't get enough credit. Let's see. Who else are we seeing? Serving. Gail because she just goes for it and I love it. What's the last skill? I forgot. Hitting. Ooh, that's a tough one, because there's a lot of strong hitters, but there's cagey hitters like Glory Cotis. So I don't know, but you know what? I think I'm going to have to pick MVP, my partner, Carolyn Kirby, because she never gets a serve, and she's the greatest at everything, so that's my pick. All right, enough of this lame volleyball skills. We want to know who's the best at other more important things. Let's see. Most likely to show up at a party... Definitely Chris Schaefer, Kenji Gardner.
If Liz is throwing the party, we're definitely there.
We're there.
The Reebok parties, that whole thing.
I'm willing to bet if anybody throws a party, we're there.
We're pretty likely to be there.
Most likely to chug beers fastest, Elaine Roque, definitely.
Liz, that's simply not true. I don't believe in drinking much, and when I do, I drink like a lady.
Most likely to show up with a different guy every time, Aaron Dieters, you got it. actually, Liz, simply not true. I have at least four or five friends in every part of the country.
Yes.
And the biggest eater is me. Mm-hmm. I haven't met a meal I haven't liked yet.
I knew I liked Liz. I'm right there with her.
That's good shtick. That is good shtick by Liz Masakaya.
Oh. She's a character.
We hope you're enjoying it. 9-4 right now, Fontaine and Forsyth.
All right, folks,
which
back
I wish it wasn't so humorous.
Championship game.
And Liz Pick is best defensive player, Mark Fontaine, and now digging in, probably to pass this next ball, brought to her by Carolyn Kirby. They're up 9-4 as we move towards 15 and a winner here at Volleyfest 94.
Good, good.
Forsyth.
Go.
Ball control is losing a little bit, but that time they are fortunate. The set was very close, and that's all Forsyth could do with it. Kirby was all over it, but they can't capitalize. Side out going, not a Barbara Fontana.
You know, where we're standing, it does not seem to be very windy, but it's very possible that there's wind gusting with all of these tall buildings around here, because you're seeing a lot of setting errors, a lot of sets that are blowing onto the net.
It might even be circling. It looks like it's going cross court right now. You would think it might be blowing off the ocean, which would mean that Masakaya and Kirby would be on the good side. Good stuff.
It's amazing when you watch Carolyn Kirby hit how far she travels in the air. She takes off so far behind the ball. She more so than anyone out here keeps the ball in front of her shoulder.
Liz Masakaya. And caught in between steps that time. The set was drifting there also, Maria, which means we take the turn at 11-4. And on this side change, Kirby and Masakaya could be the champ. We'll see you in a minute.
Oh, so it's my fault.
I didn't say that.
Well, then what do you say?
You don't listen.
You never change.
The new Volkswagen Jetta has an adaptive automatic transmission. It senses the way you drive and adjusts to fit your personality.
Maybe you are.
Maybe I'm not.
It's a shame we only make cars.
This is for all those commercials that show women content with seeing their reflections in dinner plates or coffee tables. Serious performance shoes from Reebok. Available at over 400 Foot Action stores nationwide.
The new Volkswagen Jetta GLX was built for the Autobahn, where people go 130 miles an hour. You, however, cannot. If you could, it would look a lot like this. And a little like this.
Western Auto has over 100,000 parts available when you need them 7 days a week. Serious parts at serious savings. Hey, we know what you want.
Save on Castrol Motor Oil now at Western Auto. Castrol, maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown.
Western Auto, no stranger to these parts.
We're back on the beach, albeit a man-made one here downtown Long Beach, the promenade. Bill McDonald, Maria Barnes. I'm here for Drew, who's in Mykonos, the Greek islands, hopefully enjoying his honeymoon. We can always hope, can't we? Here we go, Liz Masakaya to serve. They're up 11-4.
No one cut.
Nobody there, but once again, Kirby there defensively. We could go 12-4. Oh, the Fontana, the big-time dig. Unfortunately, Forsyth's bump not high enough, and Fontana couldn't get to it. So a great play nullified, and another point, an 8-point lead.
Fontana looks very frustrated right now. Their game is just really broken down. Their ball control is not what it normally is.
And Masakaya and Kirby, they sense the kill right now. They want to get it over quickly because they were out that, what, hour and 13 minute extravaganza in the semifinals.
Against Richardson and Canoop.
Yeah, so the longer that this one goes, the more of a chance that Fontana and Forsythe could come back. Fontana, Kirby, reading her like a comic book that time. Right there in 13-4. And that's just frustration because Fontana and Forsythe, they're the team out here that can beat Kirby and Massakion.
So amazing about Kirby and Massakion. You saw how quickly they dropped off the net and dug that ball. They're so cagey and so quick on defense. You never know where they're going to be next.
How about serving, acing our leaders?
Best serving team on the
there
beach.
There it is. In this tournament, Carolyn Kirby, we're seeing her. And after that, nobody else in our final.
Chris Schaefer, young player. I think they got seventh this weekend. Marlo Hare, who played with Marie Anderson. That was a new partnership.
You mean the Chris
they
Schaefer?
They played very well.
Chris Schaefer can do that, even though she goes to all those parties?
Yes, she can still serve the ball.
That's right. After a night of partying, Schaefer can come back and get it done on the ace. When we come back, it's 13-4. Kirby and Massakion in charge. See you in a minute.
Entire city of Seattle on the roof of my car.
Now my car has wings, feathers, and a beak.
A little glue, a few seeds, just add water, and voila!
It's not what you add on to our car that makes it more fun. It's what you take off. The Del Sol from Honda.
Right now, your Honda dealer is offering attractive lease rates on the Del Sol S.
We're back, the Promenade in Long Beach, the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour. This is Volleyfest 94, the Promenade, and what a great place to hold a tournament. I'm Bill McDonald along with Maria Barnes. You know, we know what Forsythe and Fontana have been saying to each other. What are those two saying during a timeout?
All right, ladies.
Probably Hakuna Matata. They're up 13-4.
You say it so well. Hakuna Matata. No worries.
You've seen The Lion King.
That's right, from the great Disney movie. There's Barb Fontana digging in. She'll get the serve. And the rainbow out, and we have reached championship point at 14-4 for Massakion and Kirby. Can they win another? It would be their 10th of the year. And they're 22nd together. Championship point number one. Fontana says, not yet, not if I can help, and a little bit of vocal to support that big slap.
As we've mentioned a couple times, both these teams have got to be fatigued. It's great to see Barbara pound a ball like that towards the end of the match. They've both played a lot, traveled home from Russia from the Goodwill Games just late Wednesday night. So they've still got that jet lag going.
Maybe that goodwill between these two from the Goodwill Games will disappear. Oh, Fontana with the dig, tight set, the joust won, kept alive, no way, and it's going to be a point for Fontana and Forsythe at 5-14. So they ain't dead yet, folks.
Fontana working really hard. She gets the great dig. Then she gets a tight set from her partner and goes up with the joust and just powers the ball back down on Massakion's side.
Lori to serve. Down by nine. One more look at the joust.
See there, that ball is over the net. I mean, Barbara did an amazing job to be able to get up and over and stuff that.
The wind really blowing now.
Very gusty wind here.
I say it's really blowing. Then you were telling me about Myrtle Beach when it was really blowing.
Howling.
Yep. Smart play. Don't need power, you need placement. And we'll have championship point number two for Carolyn Kirby. We talked about our best of the beach coming up. Carolyn won that last year, the best of the beach.
She really is the best player on the beach. I mean, she set records with Angela Rock. She set records with Nancy Reno. Now she's setting one with Liz Masakayan. She elevates her partners because she's so consistent and so good at everything.
Fontana will take it. Good little cut that time around the block. And staying alive with the side out Fontana at 5-14. Fontana out of Manhattan Beach, California. She's a South Bayer.
She's engaged to be married in October to Charlie, who's also an attorney and was on the 1992 U.S. water polo team.
Kirby puts it away.
Kirby lays it in. Liz Masakayan back to serve. Third time
around. Montana has won two events. Forsyth, five. Kirby, 50 wins. 50 championships. Trying to make it 51 right here for partner. Can put it in play, and they can get this point.
Montana coming up with the right shot
again. It. And another side out to Fontana and Forsyth.
Montana and Forsyth have steadied out here. If they can make a run for this next side switch. So just one more point.
You figure if it was against anybody else, maybe they could come back. Maybe make the miracle, but it would really take something. And right now they're doing it, however. And we're going to have to change sides. Give credit where credit is due. Fontana and Forsyth not folding up. They're battling back, and it's 6-14.
They are a steady enough team to make a comeback against Kirby and Masakayan. They have done it before. Fontana just right in position to dig that ball, and that's a great cagey cut shot by Forsyth.
The classic example of actually digging in for a dig that time, Barb Fontana. When we come back, they'll be out of the shade and back into the sun. 14-6. See you in a minute.
Listen to this. Chevrolet, Ford, Toyota, Chrysler, Plymouth, Jeep, Eagle, Cadillac, Pontiac, Oldsmobile, Buick, Geo, GMC trucks, Hummer.
I said only Ron Carter Autoland sells Chevrolet, Ford, Toyota, Chrysler, Plymouth, Jeep, Eagle, Cadillac, Pontiac, Oldsmobile, Buick, Geo, GMC trucks, and Hummer. All in one place, Alvin, Texas. If you want great selection, remember, a selection this great means great savings in Alvin, Texas. Ron Carter's Autoland.
Woodstock, a generation gathered to make history. 25 years later, all you have to do to change the world is change the channel. See Woodstock 94, only on pay-per-view. A historic weekend of live television and over 30 bands. Call your cable system now to order. You can always lie and say you were there anyway.
Two teams, two goals, one plan of action. To kick, throw, block, even hit their way to a win. Who's the CISL's toughest team on the turf? Detroit battles Dallas, Sunday night at 7, live on HSE.
You got it, we're back. And the Coors Light Women's Pro Beach Volleyball Tour will continue. The best of the beach. We'll find out who the best individual is out there on the sand. We'll go to Vegas. That city never sleeps, does it? October 11th, check your local listings. Part of our crowd enjoying the sun and the fun here at the Promenade. I'm Bill McDonald. Maria Barnes once again back. Maria, who's been, she could have been playing in her own match today, but she decided to come out and earn some cash here on television. 14-6, another championship point. Actually, not yet. Excuse that, because Forsyth and Fontana with the serve, and they're going to get another point. How about that? It's now 7-14.
Making a little run. As I said, they are steady enough to do it. team has so much composure. It was actually surprising to see them give away so many points in a run like that. It's rare that Kirby and Massakine get such big runs against this team. They do against everyone else, but it's rare that they do against Fontana and Forsyth.
Both these teams can dominate other teams readily and steadily. Looking for the side out, Kirby. Nice set. Off the block. And we have another, now we will have another championship point opportunity. And it will be Carolyn's turn at it.
Carolyn Kirby will serve.
They fought off a couple already. Have Forsyth and Fontana. We'll see if they can do it again and stay in the match. Kirby to serve. Yes, the hit by Forsyth.
You saw that rip of a serve by Carolyn Kirby. She and Liz Massakine both have such great serves. That's what separates them from all the other teams. They're the only team that has both players that rip jump serves, and they do it all the way through to the end of the match. It's not unusual for them to come out and close out a match with two or three aces in a row.
Barb's going to try to rip one of her own.
Got it.
Little tight turn. Oh, that's a perfect play. Is it out? It is.
Yeah.
And another point. 8-14. They're within six. And now, you know, the gritty, determined look now is replaced by, maybe we're still in this thing. The smile from Barb Fontana.
I guess Kirby and Massakine started singing Hakuna Matata a little bit too early.
Yeah. And out again. No touch. How about this? 9-14.
Kirby and Massakine have been complaining about that afternoon fog that's been rolling in for them every match this tournament, and it seems to have happened again. Massakine just set her too tight there. She couldn't really do anything with it. Kirby hits the ball out.
Their last loss, Kirby and Massakine, 2 days ago. They just roll match after match after match. Right now, they are still in a commanding situation at 14-9, but it was done a little while ago, and all of a sudden, off the mat, Fontana and Forsyth. Why?
You know, I have to believe Kirby and Massakine are exhausted mentally, and their coach was telling me about that, and it's just tough for them to make a big play time after time, to make the right decisions when you don't have that clarity of thinking when you're that exhausted, and that seems to be what's happening for them here. They're just tired, and both of these teams take off again on Tuesday for another international tournament in Japan, so there's no rest for these two.
No rest for the best. That's what happens. Everybody wants you. And you want to show yourself around the world, and that's what these two teams definitely do. Quickly, wanting to serve and keep that momentum going is Fontana. They couldn't wait for Kirby and Massakine to get back. That one somehow finds the court.
I thought that was out.
So did I at first. We'll have another try at it. Liz Massakine.
Championship point.
As I mentioned earlier, don't be at all surprised to see them end this match with an ace.
Massakine with an opportunity to do just that. Right to Forsyth. She should get a good swing at this one. Doug digging. Kirby got it, but it's out.
Kirby showing off the wheel.
You're churning and burning in that sand trying to get it, but not quite.
On the left, tried out.
That was a nice 40-foot sprint. What a great hustle play by Carolyn Kirby. Yes, I would say that they are anxious to close this match out. Look at this. She's all the way at the net. 40-foot sprint. And she's able to get a hand on it. Amazing.
Post-tournament award ceremony right now.
Look at these wheels. Massakine just cheering her on.
Yeah, isn't that great? Come on!
The other thing is, notice how low to the ground she was towards the end there. You know how hard it is to run quickly when you're that low to the ground?
Yep, I do. We're going to take a break. When we come back, more good stuff from Long Beach. Our championship match continues here at Long Beach. We'll see you after this break. Don't move. We'll be right back.
Sam Houston Race Park and see the top quarter horses in the country. Now racing Wednesday through Saturday, 7:30 p.m., Sunday at 1 p.m. Make plans now to come out to Sam Houston Race Park. Don't miss the thrill. Can you say filler up, filler up, filler up three times? Sure you can. Join in on the fun that the Texaco Summer Extravaganza offers by filling up three times with Power Plus or Power Premium by September 18th at any of the participating Texaco stations, and you'll get a free pass to Six Flags Over Texas. Filler up with Texaco and watch the Rangers Pennant Chase on HSE to get a cool deal on some hot summer fun. Hurry up. Passes are limited. So get to a participating Texaco station now.
That's just part of the gathering here at the Promenade in Long Beach. We're downtown. A little socializing going on, huh?
No comment.
Well, maybe they didn't know each other before, but they do now. 14-9, Kirby and Masakayan still trying to win it, but they're not going to do it on this serve because it belongs to Forsythe.
Cut it! Go, go!
Fontana's there. Liz right back. That's smart play. Totally out of position. You've got to put it down.
Great heads-up play by Liz Masakayan.
Chance number six, championship point.
Barb Fontana impressing everybody with her defense and her hustle. Carolyn Kirby saying, hey, let's end it right here, partner.
53 minutes is quite enough. Let's terminate this thing now. Another... record long match for them.
Could be. Good bump set though. Kept alive. Kirby to win it! Yes!
War ceremony.
Carolyn Kirby, Liz Masakayan are winners in Long Beach.
Did you notice that mini pass right in the middle of that last rally? Like, Carolyn, this is all I have left. They played really well coming out, but they kind of went into that fog again in the middle of that match. And I've got to hand it to Fontana and Forsythe to beat down that much. And to have the fortitude to come back and creep your way back to 14-9 is pretty impressive.
Here's our championship point again.
Tough pass for Forsythe, for Fontana to get to. And then see the little mini pass by Carolyn Kirby. This is a, what is this? And that's just a smart deep hit by Kirby. Very anxious to end this game where Kirby and Masakayan.
That was a good serve because it was one of those I got it, you take it serves in the middle. And that forced Fontana to have to hustle for that bump set. So it all started with a good serve by Carolyn Kirby. And there's Liz and Carolyn right there. They are your victors here at the Promenade in Long Beach. Go ahead and celebrate, guys. You won again. And for Forsythe and Fontana, we'll go get them next week. We'll be back with more. Don't go away. Lots still to come. 15-9, our final. Yes.